Welcome to my first video fully in English in this channel, my third channel right now. It's my third channel. That's a lot. That's quite a lot. So if you don't know me, because why would you anyway, I have two channels. One, it's a crime-based channel, kind of I make, you know, case videos or whatever in Spanish. And the second channel, also in Spanish, I basically do makeup videos telling stories or whatever I want to talk about, really. There's not actually a point to that channel. Now, this one does have a point, and that point is to talk about stories that are usually in Spanish so I can translate them into English. Now, this is not my first language, as you probably noticed, because of the pronunciation of the words, because I can't speak for the life of me in Spanish, let alone English. I actually do mix both languages. I actually do all of the time. And because videos are edited, nobody notices that I do not know how to even speak in Spanish. For my first story, actually, I wanted to talk about something that has been on my mind for the past 2 weeks. I've already talked about this, actually. I have it on TikTok and also in my second YouTube channel. That is because it's really, really hysterical. It's a funny story, but at the same time, it's such a tragedy. Actually, we shouldn't be laughing about it. And I've said that in my second channel, like, this is not a laughing story. At the same time, it really is, because it's insane. It's ridiculous. So I'm gonna start talking about the dog that killed 3 people. Here are my Instagram, TikTok, and other accounts. Actually, my other accounts are not going to be in this video, but on my description down there, so like, go check them out if you speak Spanish or maybe you want to practice. And let's start with the story of the little dog that killed 3 people one fateful day 30 years ago. By the way, this is a story in Spanish because it is from my country, Argentina. So, that said, let's continue. This happened in Caballito, this place. If you don't know, why would you know? Caballito, Buenos Aires, Argentina, in 1988. As I said, it's been more than 30 years. The date was October 21st, and it was a beautiful, very, very normal, usual, just your common, normal, nice day. It was a nice, like, nobody was expecting this, okay? Nobody was expecting this to happen. This story takes place actually in an avenue, so a lot of people were coming and going. They were, you know, shopping around, maybe, you know, getting some groceries. Some were taking the bus. An avenue filled with people. Everyone just not expecting anything. So, there was this building, I don't know how many floors it had, but I can tell you, in the 13th floor of this place, there was a little dog. Now, this dog is here known by the name Caniche. It is a Caniche. That is how we refer to this race of dogs. You may know it by Poodle or maybe Poodle Toy. Everyone hates that dog, I have to say it. Everyone hates that kind of dog because it's really loud, it's really noisy. It's kind of a coward dog, but at the same time not. It's so not funny. So the balcony in which this dog was had to be repaired. That means that there were, you know, a little bit of holes here and there, some things to be fixed. The little dog, the little rascal, decided to just throw himself off one of those halls. I guess you know what happened by now. The avenue was filled with people. There was a lady, a 71-year-old lady, that was walking by with her groceries bags and just, you know, looked up and there was a dog falling in her head, okay? The dog just right in there, killing her instantly. Also, yeah, if you're wondering, the dog died. Now, that would be the end of it, okay? That would be the end of the story itself. That's already tragic and weird. But no, the story doesn't, you know, just end there. No, it's chaos. It's filled with chaos. So this little poodle that just fell actually was called Catchy. We call him Catchy. Well, that day Catchy decided to not go alone to the other side. He decided he was going to kill more people, and you know what happened? Then again, this was an avenue, so lots of people were shocked by the sight. It was like, what? just happened. Does anybody know where this dog came from? So a lady was, you know, just wondering what happened and looking at the scene. To be completely honest, we have no idea what she was thinking of, what was going through her head at that point, if she was just in shock or if she was thinking of going to the other side to help. But the thing is, she stayed right in the middle of the street. I'll say it again, there were a lot of people, a lot of traffic, cars, buses, everything that you can imagine was there. She was hit by a bus almost immediately after the other lady was hit by the dog. Dog falls, lady dies, then this lady is run by a bus. Nobody can believe what just went down. And that is not the end of the story either. Well, everyone starts getting off of the bus. People start looking at what just happened again. Everyone is calling emergencies, everyone's talking about what's happening. And all of a sudden, a man just falls to the ground, has a full-on heart attack. People call an ambulance immediately. He is rushed to the hospital, but sadly, he passes away before getting there. The dog actually took 3 lives with him, and it was all in mere minutes, right? Because one thing happens, everyone's in shock, okay, this just happened, it's so weird. Then a lady just is run over by a bus, and then a man is just standing there like, this is completely out of nowhere. And by the shock, the surprise, and probably some, you know, heart issues, he just dies. It's one of the weirdest stories I've ever told. I've been doing this. I've been telling stories for 5 years, maybe more, I don't know. And it's just ridiculous. I cannot even imagine this story being real, and it is. It fully is real. It happened here, it happened in Argentina, and many people know this, actually, the people that got to see the news as death by poodle, or, you know, killed by dog, or whatever, you know. Maybe some of you know this story. Maybe you think it's like an urban legend. Well, it's not. It actually happened 30 years ago in here, like a couple neighborhoods away from me. It's ridiculous. It's just, oh my god, I can't. It's so tragic, like nobody was looking for death that day. Like nobody was like, oh my god, I want to die right now by a poodle falling on my head. Like nobody was prepared to die that day or to see so much chaos. Can you imagine that? You know, the people that died, it was an instant. Okay, they maybe didn't even notice. The people that were, you know, surrounding them, was like one surprise here, one surprise there, all of a sudden just death. Imagine being there consumed by fear of what's happening, and you think, okay, this is the end of times, everyone's dying, what? But yeah, no, I don't know. As I said on my TikTok, you do not know what is going to happen. The next day, you just go into the streets. Do not fear, okay? Do not fear, do not just lose all of your senses to this. Nothing is going to happen. Nothing is going to probably fall in your head, but just, you know, just every time you're near a building, it has balconies, consider looking up, you know, like seeing if something's about to fall, whatever. Actually, after telling the story on my second channel, I received a lot of people, the fact that a dog had fallen in their heads, actually, you know, it's not always a building. It could be a 2-story house. It doesn't need to be that, but yeah, has happened. Again, to more people. Actually, yeah, there are people getting hit in the head by dogs. Just like, okay. So take care, maybe. Maybe just look up. That being said, then again, subscribe if you would like more stories from my country or other Spanish regions, really. And I'll be doing that, so goodbye, I guess. I do not know how to say goodbye any other way, really. In this language, I've never practiced that actually, so I don't know. Bye bye, I guess. Bye.